Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
It's time for another daily dose of dismal Disney. We did not expect this one.
No.
Apparently, the big news today is Disney is pushing back the Rachel Zegler Snow White live action remake, and it looks like we're actually getting dwarfs, but we're getting CGI dwarfs.
Right, so why couldn't you just hire dwarf actors to begin with? Because you're trying to fix it now, actually after the fact. You're trying to go back retroactively and make it dwarfs because you know you pissed everybody off.
Yeah, it's called fix it in post. That's what they usually do. Fix it in post-production, and it sounds like they're pushing this movie back to fix it. Will they admit that they screwed up? Probably not. They're probably going to say, this was the plan all along. But now it's even worse.
Bull crap.
Now it's even worse because now there are 7 dwarf actors who don't get a job.
Right. I thought there were 7 magical creatures.
7 magical creatures. So let's talk about this. Let's talk about this in a very special episode of Clownfish TV. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. You'll get a woohoo if you do.
Woohoo.
And we got to give a hat tip to Mike Phelan, who actually posted an article on piratesandprincesses.net about it. But this isn't the only announcement today. They moved some other
movies around and stuff too. No, Snow White was one of them. So Snow White's getting pushed back from March 22nd, 2024 to March 21st, 2025. They're also moving back an untitled Disney film, but that's only going back a couple months. There's an untitled Disney film that was supposed to be released on Valentine's Day, and now it's moving to April 5th next year. And then there was one that was supposed to be, that Elio was supposed to be March 1st next year, and now it's moving to June 13th in 2025.
That's over a year. So this tells me there's, that might have problems too, because that's a Pixar one. That's one that.
Right, and there's another Pixar one that they can put, an untitled Pixar film that's been removed from the schedule. And there's an untitled Disney film that was being removed from the schedule on the date that they moved Snow White to.
Okay, so this kind of goes along with the rumors that, Pixar is not in very, very good shape now either. They're trying to course correct at Pixar.
Right. Well, all they did was take the 2 dates that they had. They moved Elio back to one, and then they moved Snow White to another. And then those other movies that are on those dates are just now pushed off to we don't know when. Is basically what they did.
Okay, so let's dive into this. They kind of snuck it onto their website today.
Oh, it wasn't going to sneak anywhere. Everybody was like, oh, did you see this?
So for those of you who have missed the drama, the live action Snow White remake has landed with a thud with a lot of people. Originally, Disney said that they weren't going to use dwarves at all. They were going to have magical creatures. And then this leaked image showed the diverse thieves or whatever the hell they
bandits.
Were supposed to be. Bandits.
And now here's the thing. They can't say, well, oh, they're just stand-ins. And that, you know, because the dwarves look nothing like them. The costumes are nothing like them.
No.
You know what I think? I think there's so much backlash that they're now trying to put dwarves in the movie with CGI, but they still didn't hire dwarf actors.
Because they can't. Because they already filmed it. So what do you do? If you've already filmed the movie, without actual dwarf actors, right? 7 people who probably would love to have that job, except for Peter Dinklage, who was angry about it. You go and you just, well, take CGI and throw it on top of the diverse stand-ins. I mean,
well, they're going to argue, oh, we were, this is our plan the whole time. Bullshit.
No, it wasn't.
Bullshit. This is called so much backlash. Now you're pushing it back a year, saying it's the Hollywood strikes. This one was already supposed to be almost done.
Yeah, so that's the thing too. If this movie was actually coming out when they said it was coming out, and it was already in the can, it was already finished, whatever. It was coming out in March. It was March, right?
Yeah,
it was
coming out March 22nd, yeah.
There would have been leaked images already. Just to calm the fire, Disney would have released images of the dwarfs. They would have said, no, it's fine, guys. See,
we have dwarfs. But they never did. They kept saying we're doing magical creatures. And then it was bandits. And those were like, the bandits was like an official write-up or something.
Yeah.
Bandits. And now it's the dwarfs. And they're going to argue they meant to do that the entire time. But you know damn well they're full of shit. They're getting their ass handed to them. People are calling them out for their bull crap. And now they're trying to retroactively go back and fix it. Except now it just looks worse the whole way around because they will not let this one die. And now, instead of hiring dwarf actors, they're doing CGI in post to try to make them look like dwarves.
Yeah, and we had some other dwarf actors like Dylan Postal, who played Hornswoggle in the WWE, calling out Peter Dinklage. And I know he made the rounds, and he was like, what the hell? There would be a lot of actors of my stature that would have really appreciated an opportunity to be in a big Disney movie like this, and you just done screwed it up. So now we got CGI. CGI dwarfs.
And of course, they made it look like fuzzed out, so it's hard to like really clearly see them well.
Dopey, you know? Dopey looks like Alfred E. Newman from Mad Magazine.
This is like the Polar Express levels of CG right here.
Yeah, it's not good. So this version here is coming from Screen Rant. Snow White live action remake reveals first look at Rachel Zegler with CGI dwarves after major backlash.
I think everybody knows that Disney's just trying to, you know, retcon the whole thing at this point.
The summary though, this is interesting. Okay, Disney's live-action Snow White is facing controversy over the portrayal of the dwarf characters, originally replacing them with magical creatures, but receiving criticism for lack of representation of actors with dwarfism.
Correct.
The new image reveals that the dwarves in Snow White are now CGI characters, which further diminishes the opportunity for casting actors with dwarfism.
Because they, like you said, they filmed it with the other people, the magical creatures.
Yes.
The people that look like the actors in that image. And now they're trying to retroactively go back and be like, oh, no, we didn't. Oh, Daily Wire's coming for us with a Snow White people want to see. Shit.
Right.
We're going back and fixing. Oh, look, there's dwarves. There's always been dwarves. I swear.
I mean, it does not help that you've got the son of the director who worked with Walt Disney directly, and the son is saying that Walt and my dad are spinning in their graves because this is what you did to Snow White. This is what you think of Snow White. And you've got Rachel Zegler out there shooting off her mouth.
Well, she's been saying lately.
I think they gagged her.
And you know what else? It said Disney seems to be responding to audience feedback and attempting to address the controversy, but the movie's delay suggests it still has time to make changes and reinvent itself. The problem is, as we reported before, their budget's out of control. There's no way this movie's going to make its money back. There's no way in hell it's going to make this money back. Weren't they saying it was like $300 million now, and that was leading up until next year? That was without a year and having to redo everything?
Yeah,
you better just take the loss.
I think what they're doing at this point, they're spending the money to do damage control, and I think they're trying to show people that they're trying to course correct somewhat. And that doesn't help that, you know, the South Park episode came out with the Panderverse,
yes.
And the whole episode was about Disney making stupid ass decisions mm-hmm. to pander. There's not a single brown skinned dwarf in the whole lot. What the
hell? Well, I can't really tell because it's so dark.
They have time to change that, right? But yeah, this is a more classic version of Snow White. And if they had released this, well, people still would have said this looks like shit.
Hey, look at that and look at the magical creatures.
They're not the same.
No.
No.
Not even really. Look at the diversity there. No diversity in the dwarves now.
None at all. So yeah. It's exactly what you thought. They got a lot of backlash, and they're like, ah, shit, how do we fix this? Okay, well, we'll delay it a year, and we'll just use CGI to cover up the magical creatures.
How they could have fixed it was cancel it.
Yes.
That honestly was, you know, the best thing you could have done at this point was cancel the damn thing. Take the loss, take the write down, whatever. You know, make sure it's destroyed and no one ever sees it ever.
So... According to Screen Rant, the change to the magical creatures backfired on Disney. You
yes.
don't say. You don't say. Instead of embracing the supposedly more politically correct change, Disney was criticized for its failure to give actors with dwarfism the opportunity to take on dwarf roles.
They still aren't. They're putting these CGI things in now.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's going to look even worse if they say, oh, we're just reshooting it with actors with dwarfism after that's what you showed. This is after CGI crap.
While the Snow White casting damage has already been done, as a CGI dwarf is not an inclusive step in any way that casting an actor with dwarfism would be, it seems Disney is trying to listen to critical response. No, they're just trying to save their ass at this point. Mm-hmm. I mean, 1 year is a lot of time, and they can fix a lot. I mean, this is going to be really interesting to see how this movie, and I wonder if we're going to see the rough edges where they weren't able to like cut stuff out completely, or
I don't know. But the thing is, people are like, oh, they're going to replace Rachel Zegler. Apparently not, because even in this image, she's still Snow White. So Rachel Zegler's apparently staying. And then there's seven CGI dwarfs that look like ridiculous.
Oh God. So here is the official release from Disney. The film, which stars Rachel Zegler, invites audiences back into the magical world of Snow White with beloved songs and recognizable characters such as the Evil Queen and, of course, Dopey, Grumpy, Sneezy, Bashful, Happy, Sleepy, and Doc.
Yeah, because look at the magical creatures again, because you totally got that, you know, here. That was clearly, you know, they were all those characters.
Yeah, which one of you guys wants to be Dopey? You know, like, come on. This is such bullshit. They better not try to hose people and be like, this is what we planned all along.
They are trying to hose people. They are definitely trying to do that now. But even Screen Rant's like, no. We're not buying it. People aren't buying it. Disney, they're not buying what you're the shit you're shoveling.
Fixed your shit.
Yeah, fixed your shit.
I could just see somebody like, and the thing is, this is probably just a still. They probably just like photoshopped her in, cut her out, and then plopped her in with these, you know, the dwarfs or whatever. Yeah, this.
Hurry, give them something. The investor call's coming.
Well, that's exactly, yeah. This is probably because Peltz is looking like, okay, guys, got a huge freaking disaster on your hands with Snow White. What are you going to do about it? Oh, we're going to add the dwarfs. Okay, but you're still going to get, because you know this was not the plan. This was never the plan. It was supposed to be Snow White and the seven diversity hires.
Well, I think it was dwarves at first, and then Peter Dinklage complained. And then it was, no, we're doing magical creatures. And then they started putting stuff out.
God.
Wait, and then the normies who didn't know anything about any of this were like, wait, you replace the dwarves? Why would you replace the dwarves? And why didn't you hire actors with dwarfism, you know, and everything else? And now they're like, oh, we're fixing it. Then they were bandits. Then they said there was going to be bandits.
Yeah.
And now we're back to dwarves again.
Well, that's the only time Disney actually fixes anything is when it hits the mainstream press, when everybody starts roasting it. Then they think about it. It's like Marvel Comics. It was a freaking disaster. And they didn't do anything about it until it hit like Hollywood Reporter or something that Marvel Comics was in bad shape. And when the mainstream media started making fun of Star Wars, that's when they're kind of like, yeah, maybe we should rethink this a little bit. You know.
Now South Park's making fun of them all for Star Wars.
Yeah, you're a freaking joke, Disney. You're a freaking joke. You know, so.
But we're always wrong here at Clownfish.
Always wrong. We're always wrong. So, yeah, this is really interesting stuff. Now, I don't know if this is going to be indicative of Disney going forward, because we are seeing a lot of movies being moved and changed.
Well, yeah, they have to because of the strikes and everything else.
Yeah, well, that again, this gives them an excuse.
But Snow White was supposed to be pretty much done. So there was no reason.
It was done.
There was no reason to move it, except they're trying to do damage control and cover their asses. But this is not going to be any better.
No. Nope. So always remember, guys. Always remember, this is the direction they were going to go in. And I think we'll probably get a version of Snow White that is as close to the classic version as possible without having to reshoot.
It's gonna be a clusterfuck. I'm just gonna say it.
Oh yeah, it's gonna come and go like Cinderella, and nobody's gonna remember it exists.
Okay, but Cinderella, at least they didn't have to redo the whole damn thing.
No,
I don't know. That's true.
We're gonna wrap this up. Yep. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later.
Bye.